I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, it won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. Got every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes want to see is a glimpse of you. All I need is you.
Hello, church. Blessings of the Lord Jesus Christ here today. You know, God is ever so faithful. Amen. And we just have so much to be thankful for of just this wonderful season that we're in. Amen. We know that we just had a big old turkey. Come on now. So how much more should we be thankful of even that which is to come? And not only, church, do we get to, I'm just really making it plain, you know, stuff our face, hello, stuff our faces, with all the sweets and all the goods. And, you know, pastor was saying it this way, hey, you know what, I have sinned, and I ask you to please forgive me. You know, maybe many of y'all are still drawing on those pumpkin pies and all different types of cakes and snacks. And I'm telling you, they're going to be snacking us right out of here, you know, having to deal with a lot of the happies and the jolly times. Amen. And such a wonderful time that is so gracious and wonderful in the Lord. Amen. But, you know, it just always seems to me like, you know, when things are going really great and things are moving really in the spirit for the people of God, you know, the enemy is going to try to come in and really try to swoop you off your feet, literally. You know what I'm saying? And I mean, you know, just like you think of boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, and wives. You know, oh, I'm going to sweep you off your feet, you know, taking you to the balcony and literally just going all out when you get your first house. How they say, you know, you carry your wife over the threshing floor and the threshold, that you're saying, okay, here, you know, we can do something because I'm really making it special. Well, even in the midst of all that, you know, we find ourselves in different scenarios or situations that really the enemy is trying to set up booby traps, trying to, you know, set up situations that really are trying to bring the house down. Because, you know, this is a time of community. Are we listening? This is a time of love. This is a time of preparation. This is a time of unity. You know, this is the time where really, you know, this is, it's either going to make you or it's going to break you. You see what I'm saying? Because not everybody's going to be happy and end on a happy note. Because it is the holidays. You know, it's wonderful. You go into your spaces of your job and your workplace, or maybe even some of your closest friends. I mean, and you're feeling the joy of the Christmas season. You know, people are beginning to already put up their lights, even in Thanksgiving. I mean, people already we're putting up their lights, and you're going through all those situations. But you know what? When God is literally pulling you up into another level where we can not only see the things that are happening, even all around the world, right? That celebrate this day of Christmas. And, you know, I've always preached it before, and I'm still going to preach it now, that we keep Christ more in Christmas. Are we listening? And in doing so, in order to change things up, of course, that the more we are on fire and we have a distinct promise and distinct agendas and things that are not only going to be better for ourselves, but better for mankind. Amen. Because Christmas is truly about us giving. And I believe that this is only a preparation of even the time to come. That this time that God has granted unto us, that we can gather together and be in love, that we are fellowshipping in this time to actually prepare us in for that time of comings. Amen. And I'm talking about even in this year to come, for we are in the year of the 2018 and the year of 2019 are drawing near. Many people are at a place where we are saying, okay, I am here. What is the next step of my life? I need a life change. I need a life transformation. You know what? I need a Holy Ghost setup. You know what? Because I no longer want to be the same in Jesus' name. Are we listening, church? And in doing so, because you know that the year is drawing closer. Amen. You know, it was wonderful that my pastor said it this way. And I was able to go ahead and get right on in. I was realizing that these were different areas within our lives that God is wanting to speak to us in our areas where, you know what, we don't wait to the first of the year in order to act upon a cause. No, we do it prior to things. You see what I'm saying? We do it prior to things. And that's what I'm sharing with you today, how we have to do things prior and to the other things begin to accumulate, or until the other things begin to get a rise out of you, sport to speak, or saying, okay, you know what? I'm alive in this situation, but when I come into these circles, or when I come into this part of my workplace or different areas within my lives, that, you know what? I just feel like, you know what? It's that fire and brimstone. It's literally, you know, I'm just, how do they say it? You know, just my back up against the wall. You know, there's no change. There's no transformation, you know, and it's just always bad, 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 bad. I mean, there's nothing good coming out of this. You see what I'm saying? Because even when they told Jesus, can anything good come out of Nazareth? You know, so there may be certain circumstances in your life right now where you're feeling and you're saying, is there anything good that can come out of this? You know, because there's so much, maybe so much anger, so much bitter, because, you know, we come around family members, or situations that arises in this time, because you know what? Maybe you can't give all the gifts to your grandkids. Maybe you can't give all your time. Come on now. And all your love into a specific place and time. You know, I heard a great evangelist said it this way. You know what? A Christmas, Thanksgiving, any other day, that's just like any other day for me. You know, because I still call it work. I still call it, you know, Jesus is my main reason and my agenda. And so we have to move forward on this. And you know what? People are going to say what they want to say, and we can't be people pleasers, but God in us is calling us to be a God pleaser. Amen. And it's so wonderful when we can participate and do these other things, but we shouldn't wrap ourselves up and the things of the world. Amen. And even though God is saying he has sent us to the world, come on now, he sent us to the world, and sometimes we have to touch people in a worldly form, in a way of, you know what, I feel your infirmities. Yes, I feel your burdens. Yes, I feel your heartaches. But you know what? God can do something miraculously where he can literally touch and change your life, not only your life, but even in the lives to come. I'm sharing with you this, church, because even though we are around these holidays and it brings so much holly, I'm telling you, sometimes you may feel like a folly. Come on now. Where you feel the down and out because of situations that have arisen. Maybe you've had a loved one that, you know, has gone to be with the Lord, and just hard situations, you know, we're coming across, we're able to minister to some people, you know, and sometimes, you know, older generation getting older, and you have to kind of make decisions that are hard, amen, for even for our loved ones and those that are dear to us, because they can't walk that walk no more, amen, or they can't talk that talk in the sense of, you know what, like I said it before, they're elderly, and they need to be treated still as elderly, but with all respect and honor. And you know what? But a lot of our elderlies then become to be in a childlike form. And sadly, the truth, many people begin to disown their elderly. You see what I'm saying? And they're not choosing to want to love on the lovely sometimes, because it's not lovely to them. And there's just really so much hate, as well as anger and bitterness sometimes, that can be remorsed among our families. Amen. But you know what I'm here to share with you today is that don't allow that to be a stick in the mud for you. Amen. Don't allow the enemy to steal away your joy. Don't allow the enemy to put an upper hand on you when you feel like, you know what, I can't go through this. You know, through the word of God, it reminds me there out of the book of Psalms, chapter 23, verse 4. It says, yes, they are walked through this deep, this sunless. In other words, there's no sun there. And when I'm walking through this valley of this shadow of death, you know what? I will fear no evil. I will dread no evil, for you are with me. It is your rod that protects me. It is your staff that guides me. It is you that protects me to go through this. And you know, there out of the book of Psalms, chapter 37, verse 8, it says, cease from anger and forsake all this wrath. Fret not yourself. You know why? Because it only tends to doing evil. You know, God chooses us not to want to do evil, but when we set our hearts on things to do evil, or we think evil, even not only of ourselves, but that of others, you grow an offense. Are we listening? And it's almost like a plague. It's almost like a leprosy where, you know what, that it has to be cleansed. It has to be etched off. It has to be scraped off, will you may. It has to be literally released. We can't let the spirit of anger and bitterness to hold us, to keep us mad, or to keep us without our sleep. Because the Lord said, you know what? Let go of that. Don't allow that madness of a mad woman or of a mad man to keep you off of the mind of Christ. No, that's where we have to put on the armor of God. And you know what? Let the righteousness of God, let God fight your battles, because his word is so good, church. He says, vengeance is mine, says the Lord. In other words, God has your back in this. When evil is prevailing, you know what? You wrap yourself in light. Come on now. Because he has clothed us with that robe of righteousness. You know what? Because you are doing the God thing. You are doing the good thing. You know, yesterday I ministered about that of the good thing. God wants us to be that of the good thing. But it's not only that of the good thing, but it's that of the God thing. And I'm telling you, when the enemy has encircled around me, literally surrounded me, that word of God that was ministered, he said, okay, you're saying that literally your enemies are going to be eating with you. I'm going to take you through this trial. Are we listening? To see if you can surpass even the enemies that surround you. Are you listening? And literally, I said, yes, sir. Yes, sir, God. And forgive me if I backed mouth. Forgive me if I had any train of thought of otherwise. Because you know what, church? Yes, we are human. But we have to just submit that unto God. You know, because even though maybe it was not our opportunity, you see what I'm saying? Or our thinking or our doing. You know, maybe you had to follow in that way. And long and behold, there goes the enemy with a tail behind it. Come on now. But yet, even in that hard place, you know what? You got all the stars in heaven to shine bright on your behalf. You know what? Because you didn't kick, you didn't bite. You just said, you know what? I'm going to march forward on this. You see what I'm saying? And God said, okay, there you go. There you go. I'm going to give you that star. I'm going to give you, you know, that word of encouragement, because church, we need it. We need this word of encouragement, that even in that rock, even in that hard place, you know what? God can show up. He says, that's when you know that you're blessed. You know what? When you are faced, and literally, when you had set and ate with your enemies, you know, I want to read it because I really feel that maybe during this season that many are having to be around your enemies. But God has says, you prepared a meal for me in front of my enemies. You poured oil on my head. You fill my cup to overflowing, that surely your goodness and love will be with me all the days of my life, and I will live in this house of the Lord forever. You know what? Because even if God has prepared this meal, and even it may be an evil meal, hello, because it's in front of your enemies, but God has said he has poured that oil of joy, he has poured that oil over your head, that literally he will fill your cup until the overflow. In other words, you're counting all of, you could say, the downfalls and anything that the enemy wants to throw up against you. God is saying, you know what? I've given you the oil for that. I've given you the oil for that. And when the enemy knows that he can't shake that dead thing off of you, are you listening? Because it is the enemy that is attacking you. But yet God can turn it around and use it to buffet you, to create in you that which God has ordained. Because ultimately, you know what? God's word says that he's going to work all that out. He's going to work it all out according to God's goodness in your life. Because all things work for the good. Are you listening? All things work for the good to those who love God and those who are called by my name. You know, I'm sharing this podcast with you today, church, because God is calling us to submit ourselves unto God. He wants us to have a high hope and a high expectation. And I'm sharing with you, don't allow Satan to gain any advantage over you in any way when anyone has, you know what, has been any kind of offensive, or if the enemy has tried to put something over you. God is saying to forgive. We need to forgive. You know what? We need to forgive to put away wrong attitudes. We needed to forgive in order to put away our mouths. Are we listening? And you know, the Lord led me to the word of scripture. And I believe that I will be doing some live videoing, because I believe that God is saying a word here. And I know that God wants to save us from all these troubles. Amen. That there is a work to be done. And God is calling us to preach this gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. And as we are doing so, believe me, the enemy is not wanting to sit down and just going to allow you to do your thing. And I'm saying that because a lot of things come against Sister Tina. But you know what? I stand my ground. And I know that if God is for me, that who can come and be against me when God fights my battles for me? And I know that as things create for the head, I know that they trickle down to the body. And that's the reason why I believe that God has blessed me so. And he's saying, I want you to teach this word. This word I have given unto you. And I believe that there's many of those that are hearing this podcast. And I see the statistics that literally this word is going viral. And it is going around the world. And I do so appreciate of those that are hearing the word. You know what? I just count it as joy. And realizing that God is not finished in our lives, yet he is still working the sounds of miracles and wonders. And this word must be produced. This word must be shared. These personal words, these words of teachings, God is calling us that we must do this very good work. Amen. So I'm going to wrap up this podcasting, because I'm going to go ahead and do a video live as well. And I'm going into the second wind of this teaching. And I'm telling you, God is at best when you rest in him. Go ahead and cast that care on over to the Lord. Don't make it to be an offense. But know that God works on the defense of our lives, of our hearts, of our souls, and of our minds. So if you need a healing today, I will be praying for you, and I will be praying with you. Amen. That God's delivering power, literally from the very crown of your head to the very soles of your feet, that God will manifest in your life as never before, that you will enter into that land of increase. You will not fight your battles in Jesus' name. I pray that God will fight those battles for you. And even though it's read at the Apostle Paul, when he talks about, you know what, I have fought this good fight of faith. I have what? I have finished the race because I have kept the faith. God is calling many of us to keep the faith. God is the one that will complete this work that He's called us to do. But we must be at our Father's business. Amen, church? Hallelujah. So thank you for joining in with me on this podcast, as well as sharing this God-given word today. Let it, hear it again, hear it again, hear it again. And just let the blessings of God flow over your life from the very crown of your head to the very soles of your feet. Church, go to the website. I want to challenge you that if this word has been a blessing to your life, you can click onto the donation button and give a donation in for this coming year. Amen. I want to be able to be a blessing to the mission fields as well as to other pastors that go around the world, that we are sowing the seed. Amen. And these devastating areas that are ever so needed. We're doing the drive for those on the borders for the Christmas drive. Amen. Because there are those that are children, they understand. And you know, us as grown-ups, hey, you know, we can do without this or we can do without that, you know. But sometimes we as grown-ups, we kind of kick things around. Are we listening? But God is saying, you know what? Let's be a blessing this year. Amen. So as you do that, I really believe that someone can match that or begin to say, you know what? Because you've given, I want to give too. And as you give, I need you to shoot me a message through Messenger. Amen. And so that way you can receive a personal word from myself. Amen. And as well, maybe sending you a gift. Amen. From my heart and from this ministry. Amen. So God bless you, church. Thank you once again for your prayers and your support and your love and bringing forth God's word with me. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Keep on going. Keep on moving. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.